And that's what I like. I find incredible. That's what I find incredible when I do group sessions with students. I don't, if I see students that have walls up, right? They're angry or they're anxious or they're frustrated. I don't necessarily focus my attention to them to zap them into consciousness, right? I let them be in their mind. And I interact with the students that want to interact, right? And get the conversations going. And I keep an eye out on the students that are wandering, right? Which is okay for them to do. But I look at them on the periphery to watch their body movement, to watch their eye movement, to see if they're all of a sudden starting to pay attention. And if they're starting to pay attention, I keep on going with that topic and I slowly start engaging them, bringing them in, right? Now, just imagine right now with class sizes, a teacher trying to manage large class sizes like this. Impossible. That's why my belief is for me, I don't like having groups larger than 10 people. 10 is pushing it. Ideally, no more than 5 people. You can do more than 5 as long as you've worked with each of those students individually and you've brought them up to the same level and you know what they're capable of, right? Which is really important, in my opinion, when you're working with a classroom, right? To keep the class size small, to interact with the students individually. Bring them up to a certain level that they all have a common core knowledge, right? Common understanding of the topic you're talking about, and keep that momentum going and engage with them and grow that group together. The problem occurs in class size in our education system. One of the main problems is all of these students shift from class to class, right? So the knowledge base, the interaction, the communal feeling that the students may have disappears from one class to another class. So teachers can't keep an eye out on students that may be having a hard time to engage them, to bring them into the conversation, right? Extremely important. The way out of this is to have small class sizes and any centralized institution, organization, government, if anybody comes out that says class size doesn't matter, you know they're talking crap. You know they have as either a secondary agenda or they're parroting propaganda, okay? Or they're just straight out ignorant. They've never worked with the system, they don't understand what it is, right? Class size matters. Smaller the class size, the better the education, period. Okay.